Number 22 at forward, 6'1 and 1/2 senior, Jay Scheidler. Number 30 at forward, 6'1 senior. Number 52 at center, 6'3 senior, Nathan Snouts. Number 10 at guard, 5'9 junior, Dave Wagner. Number 14 at guard, 5'9 senior, Dave Hesher. And the coach, Ron Felling. The reserves for Lawrenceville are Ron Gear, Gaines, Kavanaugh, Sullivan, Stevens, and Pace. Ray Scott. And this is the game for third place in Illinois High School Class A competition. And the place is full. A lot of interest in this ball game. And the Indians of Lawrenceville come off with it. And up with it. And he puts them on the board. Nathan Schnauz puts him on the board first. That's Anglin. He'll do a lot of the controlling of the ball. That's Hart back to Anglin. They're trying to get it into Haypack inside. We've got a whistle underneath. And it looks like we've got a foul called on number 52. Nathan Schnauz. Now, the big interest here, other than the ball game, which, and there's Haypack, he's in for a quick layup. Missed it, rebound saved nicely. Very nicely saved. And Buda Western continues to, Buda Sheffield, I should say, continues to control it. They're trying to give it away, but can't. Shot from the side by Hart. And that knocks the score up. But as I was saying, Jay Scheidler of Lawrenceville can break the all-time tournament scoring record for four games. And he can even go after the all-established one of all-time tournament scoring records. And we'll have more on that a little bit later. Anglin has it. Goes all the way, lays the ball off nicely to Nielsen. Beautiful pass by Kevin Anglin. That's Dave Wagner.
They're in a man-to-man, Max. They're just going to play Jay Scheidler. Jeff Calvert's got the assignment.
Calvert's going to try to stick as close to him as he can. There they are.
Look
beautiful
at that pass.
Beautiful pass. Apex comes off with it for the Rams. Anglin down the right side. All the way to the baseline. Looking inside at Nielsen. Now he goes down the baseline. Great pass back. Oh, what a fine display of laying that ball off at the right time, Ed.
You wonder if Jay Scheidler might not be saying to himself, well, I've been shooting a lot. Maybe it's better if I give that ball off to my teammates a bit tonight.
We've got a foul called. Foul was called on, who had the foul? Number 34. Haypack had the foul. Haypack had the foul.
It came after the shot. It came after
right.
The shot was away. That's
so we don't have, we have no free throw. That's Pickering. Pickering, there was some doubt whether or not he would even start. Beautiful lead pass. And Buda Sheffield goes up by six. Jay Scheidler hasn't had a shot yet, Ed.
No.
Well, he's got a chance to really put his name in a record book that'll stay there for a long time. There's his first one of the evening, and it's a little short, but he was fouled.
Well, you see the size of this young man, 6 foot one and a half, 185 pounds. He's strong. There's Ronnie Felling, the coach at Lawrenceville.
There's his first point of the evening. Free throw shooting we've had a lot of in this last day, or today particularly, an outstanding free throw shooting. As Jay Scheidler gets his first 2 points of the ball game, brings Lawrenceville back within four. We're approaching the 5 minute mark of the first quarter. Anglin has it in the corner, that's Calvert. Back to Anglin. Shot up, taken off by Snout. He moves it himself down the right side of the court. Gets it back out to Hacher. Wagner with it. Hacher has it, back to Wagner. That's Pickering. Here he comes. Great reverse pivot, great body control. Man, oh man, he can show you some kind of body control. Quickly as Anglin, he wanted to go all the way. Calvert saves it. The other side, it goes to Hartz. He starts to the baseline. Inside, outside, shot from the baseline by Dave Hartz. And the Buda Sheffield, 10, Lawrenceville, 6. That's Jay Scheidler, probably one of the outstanding players, without a doubt, to come here in a number of years. Rams coming back. They're up by two. We've got a foul call on number 14. Fisher, Dave Fisher. He's a 5'9 senior. Lawrenceville with four seniors on their starting club. And Buda Sheffield, an all-senior starting group. Nielsen gets it to Hanglin. He's going right down the lane. Lays it off nice to Hart for 15 feet.
Max, the all-time for the Class A, four games, Don Robertson scored 123 points. Played at Thompson in 1972. Right now, Jay Scheidler has 118.
Dave Hesher scores for Lawrenceville. Brings them within two. We've got 3 minutes, 16 seconds in the first quarter. Anglin starts his drive. And we've got a foul on Dave Hesher. Hesher.
So Jay Scheidler needs 5 points to tie the record for the Class A.
Class A.
Four.
Wilson tried to get the ball on this side to Anglin, or to Hartz it was. The ball's knocked out of bounds. And the Rams will inbound it. Hartz has it. Gets it in the backcourt to Anglin. Lawrenceville in a straight man-to-man, and they're pressing. They play tough defense the whole way. Ball goes out of bounds, and Buda Sheffield will take it underneath their own basket. Anglin to inbound the ball, right under the basket. Easy shot, missed by Nielsen. And he's a little upset with himself, I think, over missing that shot. And we're going to have a jump ball right in front of Buda Sheffield's basket. Controlled by Lawrenceville, quickly down the floor to Wagner. He's got an easy two. And that brings Lawrenceville back to a tie with 2 minutes and 45 seconds remaining on the clock. It's all knotted up. Anglin. Inside it goes to Nielsen. His shot up on the board, no good, and a foul call underneath. On Pickering, the foul was called on Pickering.
One of the record, we point these out simply because of the fact that they are in the books. Dave Robish of Springfield has the all-time for both the A and AA four-game mark of 152 points set in 1967 here in the when they still had just one classification.
Ron Nielsen on both of those free throws to give Buda Sheffield that two-point advantage again. Scheidler lays it off. Man on the floor. That's Pickering. Wanted to take it. Gets it off to Scheidler. Calvert on him. Scheidler from the top of the circle. And I'll tell you, that Jeff Calvert was on him. A high score again. Anglin quickly down the court. Lays it off on the right side. They get it underneath. The Apex shot is up and no good.
Pickering really just tried to stand there. You know, he tried to assume the position and not move, but they called a foul on him.
Oh, into the ball game is Rob Horton. First shot. Yeah, that was Lonnie Stevens that came in for Lawrenceville. I read you off Horton, who's with Western. So we've got Lonnie Stevens in the back court for Lawrenceville. Scheidler working for that shot. Now that was a pretty good defensive move.
Yes, it was.
By Hartz. And he just got him by the hand. And that's what they were trying to do to him today at, with that zone and a chaser and a two-timing. And he only got 48.
They indicate he was not in the act of shooting. I might question that because Jay is usually in the act of shooting.
Yeah, right. Wagner. Beautiful shot. Dave Wagner, a 5'9 junior, just moved Lawrenceville to a tie again. The Rams are down. That's Anglin. In the corner, back to him.
Now we're going with a zone for Lawrenceville.
Anglin got the bounce that time. Buda Sheffield up by two. Buda Sheffield there in a man-to-man. Hersher. Wagner back to Hersher. Wants to get it to Scheidler. Now Jay's got it. 30 foot. He went after that rebound, too. He follows the ball about as well as anybody I've seen, Ed. Anglin. In the corner to Calvert. Back to Anglin. Man open underneath. They didn't see him. Chapek takes his shot. Lawrenceville comes off nicely with a rebound.
That's good
Hersher
ball.
Has
didn't
hurt
contact
anything.
There, but it didn't mean anything. And
no. A lot of times you'll get that call, though.
Yes, it really is a foul. There was contact, and I guess if you wanted to be very technical, but I appreciate the official that looks at it, says really it's not a factor in the game.
Dave Hartz was called for that foul, and Lawrenceville takes it out of bounds. Hersher. Scheidler. That one had 2 points on it from the time he got it in his hands. 29 seconds remaining. 10 points for Jay Scheidler in this the first period.
Scheidler needs one more point to tie the record for the Class A. He has 122. Dave Don Robinson's record is 123.
Anglin. They're going to go for one here, Ed, looks like. Like to get it inside to the big redhead. 8 seconds. Seven. Foul.
There's Chip Giovanni. Look at his smile on his face. A real class guy.
Hapek got the foul.
Look out.
That's it. Oh, I thought that. Scheidler with 10 points in the first quarter, and Ron Nielsen has 6 for Buda Sheffield. And here we go into the second quarter. Lawrenceville again controls the tip. Stevens with the ball to Wagner. Tried to get it underneath. Stevens gets it back. The ball is kicked out of bounds. Went off the leg of Ron Nielsen. And Lawrenceville will take the ball inbounds at their end of the court. The game knotted up at 18-all just into the second quarter.
Jay Scheidler even chews his gum hard. Well, he works with that.
He does everything hard, playing offense and defense. Outside more than we've seen him. He's not usually out that high. There's Scheidler.
Well, that's it. He now has the record for the Class A. He just scored his 12th point. He's now scored 124 points in the 4 games thus far.
Well, a new record has been set, and the man on one of the gentlemen on the floor just said it. Jay Scheidler of Lawrenceville. You can
see Anglin driving. Scheidler takes his position, is going back, gets knocked down. He does that very well, Ray.
Well, Jay Scheidler is averaging 37.3 points in tournament action. That's from the super sectional through now. He's shooting at a 45% clip in tournament action only, and his free throw percentage, a whopping 85%. Points now for Jay Scheidler of Lawrenceville. Let me just say again that the Assembly Hall is jam-packed for this third place game, and a lot of them are here to watch one of the finest shooters in a long time.
They're going to play defense. He's fronting the man. Really does a great job.
Shot from the corner. Tarts. Nicely by Steven. Lawrenceville is up by four now, 22-18. 6 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the second period. Scheidler with it again. 25 feet. Round and out. Beautiful rebound by Hersher. No, that's Wagner. And a three-second violation against Lawrenceville. Rob Horton coming in the lineup for Buda Sheffield. And going out is Ron Nielsen.
The rest of the players in this Lawrenceville club they're taking their shots when they get them, and that's what they should do.
Well, it takes a lot of pressure off a guy Scheidler. Anglin quickly down the court. Western needs to come back and get one. They're down by four. Hart's in the left corner. Bill has it. Gets up to Apex underneath. His shot, good. Apex gets his sixth point. Apex gets his sixth point of the night, and he has certainly performed well. He is the right now sixth ranking scorer in tournament action. Wagner gets it to Hersher. There's Scheidler from about as far out as, you know, how far is that race, Scott? 30 feet? We'll need a tape measure pretty soon. Quite a performer. Anglin with it. Wants to get it inside. Can't. They back off nicely. There's a looping pass underneath. The ball slapped down by Hersher. And they're going to call a foul on him. Dave Hersher gets the foul. Is at the line.
He has a strange free throw. All in his arms, all in his wrists.
Got them both. 8 points for Hepek. That's Wagner. Pickering. Rebound taken off nicely. Another rebound by Anglin. Quickly down the court. Lawrenceville hustling back on defense. Anglin down the middle, tries to get it off, has it blocked, knocked down, gets it back himself. Apex inside, they want to get it to him. Now they do. He goes up, it's blocked, knocked away nicely.
Beautiful move.
Up. Great block.
Schnauz came right in, he switched off his man. Beautiful move.
And we've got a foul called on Dave Hersher.
Poor Dave. You can see by his face he didn't agree with either of those two calls, and I always get a kick out of the way they look.
Max, incidentally, before the game, Dave Hersher came up to me and wanted to know if we collectively would make mention of the fact that even though the Lawrenceville team was disappointed in losing today, they wanted to make certain that the players' feelings for their coach were made known. They wanted me to make it known that they are very, very proud of Ron Felling.
I think there's a little love thing going on there. I think that's really the word that describes. And Lawrenceville, staying at the same motel we are, had one of the best pep rallies you can find in the hallways this afternoon to send their kids off to this third place game.
Had a pretty good pep rally last night at 1 a.m. too.
Jay Scheidler, left sideline, little short. Ball taken off by Calvert. The Rams coming back. They're only down by two. They did lead earlier in the ballgame. Anglin to the left corner. Baseline. Wants to get it off. Beautiful feed underneath. Oh, what a great feed that was to Rob Horton. There's Gear. Gives it to Pickering in his drive, but they've got a traveling violation called on Pickering. We've got 4 minutes and 32 seconds remaining in the second period. Buda Sheffield down by two. Albert looks inside, can't get it there. Anglin has it. He's going to control it. Guarding him closely was Wagner. There's a shot from the right corner by Hartz. Taken off nicely by Jay Scheidler. Right at the line, pass underneath. What a feed. This guy can do so many things well. And they count the basket, and a foul was called. An offensive foul was called. And we're walking to the other end of the court.
Scheidler will look at a replay on this as he comes down the... watch him dribble with his left hand now, controlling the ball, breaks through two men, complete control, goes up, finds the man wide open, and he hit... Oh, that was a foul. Whoops. Caught him right in the jaw.
Rob Horton gets his first free throw with 4 minutes and 6 seconds remaining on the clock. Got one more coming. Nice shot. And Horton is going out, and coming into the game is Ron Nielsen. Lawrenceville 26, Western 24. Gear to Wagner, to Pickering in the left corner. Jay Scheidler didn't get the roll that time. Pickering comes off with it, wants to get it inside, does, right baseline off the front of the iron by Schnauz. And Anglin comes back quickly. And there's Giovanni in the ball game. He played an all-out game this afternoon in that semifinal clash. Anglin from the left side. Schnauz come off with it quickly to Pickering. Holding up Jay Schneidler. I guess you just let the picture describe that. 18 points for
basket
Jay Scheidler.
The basket
was good.
Counts.
And a foul was called on Scheidler. That's his first.
He now has 130 points for the four games, the all-time tournament record. Dave Robich, Springfield, set at 1967, 152 points.
Boy, if you get a facial shot, there it is. What a good-looking kid that Giovanni boy is. For, I think, the first time, we're seeing Scheidler really playing out in front, bringing the ball down the court. There's another one. For some reason or other, I can just tell that when they're going in, they're beautiful. Giovanni all the way to the baseline, looking for help. Hartz has it out in front. Is it back to Giovanni? Anglin in the corner. Apek underneath. Turn around, jump shot. Good. In close. Ron Apek. 30-28. Lawrenceville by two. 2 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the second period. Scheidler, right baseline. Bingo. 20. For Scheidler. Giovanni loses control of the ball and gets it back, and I think we're going to have a double dribble call. We are. And Lawrenceville will get the ball with 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go. Absolutely a scoring machine. 24. And I've got to tell you, we've got 2 minutes and 11 seconds yet to play in the first half of this ball game.
He's not in foul trouble, only has one.
Only has one. This might be his 50-point ball game.
See how hard he chews that gum?
And he doesn't even know, I'm sure, that he's got gum in his mouth. A three-point play for Jay Scheidler. Anglin with the ball. Calvert in the corner, wants to get it underneath. Nielsen is working hard, finally gets the ball. Short, Hayback gets it back, rolls it off the back of the iron. A foul was called on Schnauz. And that's his second personal foul.
And I'm always happy to see, particularly in these third place games, you find, I usually find that the shooting improves, and technically they are, the kids are a lot looser. The pressure is
off. He missed that second shot. Scheidler from the right side.
I have him for 27. 26.
Underneath the Hayback. His shot around the iron off. Taken off nicely by Pace. Down quickly to Scheidler. He's going for it. There it is. Off the iron. And we've got a foul called. Scheidler had 26 points in the first half this afternoon. And he's got 26 points right now. And he's got a minute and 21 seconds to go. At the line is Rick Pickering. Free throw, no good. Guess who got the rebound back? Boy, he went up for that one with all the determination in the world. Lawrenceville now with a 10-point advantage, and we're right at the one-minute mark in the second period. Anglin inside. Number 44 is Horton. And Ron Horton brings Western back within eight. Jay Scheidler, Anglin to the right side. Calvert, steal by Pickering. One against two, he'll probably hold it up. Pace shot up, no good. And we're gonna have a jump ball with 28 seconds remaining. You wanna see a young man with confidence in his face if we can get a shot of Scheidler.
Young man may be hurt, is that... Well, Dave Wagner,
we can't get a shot of his face, but he's just gleaming with confidence. Yep, he's just walking around. He's oozing with confidence. And we're going to have a jump ball. Hartz and Wagner. Jump controlled by Buda Sheffield. Got a man on the floor. Looks like he's having...
season. I remember one time I was at home and I was lying on the divan. I got a cramp in one leg.
Get a Sheffield down by 10. And get the ball inbound. Anglin in the corner. That's Hashbrook.
Trailing as they are, they should take a shot.
Get the ball back to Mansmith.
Jack, how many do you have for Scheidler? 31.
And the foul was on Pickering.
31 points gives him 143 for the four games thus far.
He's got to get to 152.
152 is the four-game record set by Dave Robish at Springfield in 1967.
Rebound.
Look at
off.
That.
Boy, did he get up in the air. That would be a great replay to see that young man get up like that. He's going to take it. We've got a foul on number 42. That's Greg Mansmith. Do you think Scheidler was going for the shot?
He hit it.
You know,
he was up and hit it after the foul had been called.
Well, the thing is that his teammates know that he's going to shoot the ball about 60 or 70% of the time that they have it. And that's their game plan. Anglin quickly loops it down court, and he came awfully close to that one. That's the end of the first half, and the score, Lawrenceville 41, Western 31. Here's Ed McCauley.
Lawrenceville High School, captain of the cheerleaders, is Linda Divis. Linda, what kind of a send-off did you have for the ball club for tonight?
Well, we went around the hotel room and we went down the stairs. We got everyone out of the rooms and got them going because our team was kind of down after it, but we perked them up and we went down and did cheers. Then we had a pep session for them right before they left and we got them going.
Yeah, you had a, seemed like you had a pep session going all last night because I'm in the same hotel. You make a lot of noise. One of the girls here is Terry Gear. Where's Terry Gear? Terry, come over here, Terry. There is a young man on the Lawrenceville team named Gear. What relation?
My uncle.
He is your uncle? I thought maybe brother. Your uncle?
No, it's my uncle.
I'll be darned. That's amazing. And another name that's very familiar, Brenda Lockhart. Brenda? This is Brenda Lockhart. Your brother is?
Mike Lockhart.
Mike Lockhart, were you here a few years ago when Mike had that amazing game in the finals when Lawrenceville won it?
No.
Well, her brother put on an amazing shooting exhibition that night when Lawrenceville won their first state title here, and his name, Mike Lockhart, of course. And we have Janet Bowman. Janet Bowman and Dina Jefferson. Dina Jefferson. Janie Poe. Where's Janie? Who are you back there? I don't have your name. Come here. What's your name?
Penny Spillman.
What?
Penny Spillman.
And your name?
Kay Kaiser.
And your name?
Loretta
Faust. Well, I'll tell you, what do you think? Your team, they've just had an amazing season, I think, and you should be very proud of them.
We are.
You know, sometimes when a team loses, you feel that disappointment. I guess this afternoon, any tears in the group this afternoon?
Oh,
I would imagine. But I tell you, as I say, you should be very, very proud of the guys on the ball club. Now, do you have any plans for tomorrow that you know of?
Maybe something at the gym afterwards or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I think as I say, they deserve it, and it's really a team that has done this much for the community and for the school. Even though they lose, they've still done a great job. Well, I understand you're going to give a cheer for us, so why don't I send you out to the floor? What's the name of the cheer?
Weir.
Who?
Weir.
Weir? You mean you, me, us, Weir? That's it, huh? We're the Indians. Okay, we're going to hear Weir the Indians. Right on the floor, girls. Yes, that's part of what it's all about, as we've said many times. Come on back. Come in here once again, girls. Were any of you with the team? When was it? In 2 years ago? Were any of you with the team when they did win the state championship? Well, let's reminisce. What happened after that game when you won it?
Well, I mean, at the hotel or
just all over Lawrenceville, all over Eastern Illinois.
Well, everything. We had a caravan the whole way home, and every time we went through, they were out there. Then we went to the gym and had just a really big pep session.
Well, I'll tell you, I know that you wanted very much to win this tournament, but yet, in a way, the experience you had, I'm sure you're going to be happy for the team that does win it and the fact that you know what joy they're going to have tomorrow.
Yeah.
Girls, one other question. Any of you, how many of you are seniors?
There's three of us.
That's all? And how many juniors?
Three.
Well, now, those of you who are seniors, will you try to go on and if you go to college, will you try to become cheerleaders there?
Oh, I don't know for sure. I don't think I will.
You just can't get Lawrenceville out of your blood, the memories. Girls, thank you so much. I really admire your spirit for your team. You have a great team. Congratulations on a great year. Now, we go back to Ray Scott in Tournament Central. And you're not at all unfamiliar with those records because you had won 36 points in the final game, 1949-50, that stood for a long time, Max.
And it means a lot. Well, we're into the second half, and the ball goes out of bounds, and it will be awarded to the Rams of Buda Sheffield. They trail by 10 points, 41-31. That's Anglin with the ball. He wants to get it inside. Calvert has it. Anglin now looking inside. Ron Nielsen came up, tried to get that pass. And Hepek is working to try to get himself free. Lawrenceville in a man-to-man, and guess who steals the ball? But Anglin gets the pass right back. Jay Scheidler did a great job deflecting that ball. Anglin out in front. Hartz in the corner to Calvert. Baseline shot. Buda Sheffield is going to come out and try to get back into this ball game. And particularly, they've got to stop this one man right here. We're going to have a technical foul because Ron Felling felt that Jay Scheidler was fouled when he took that shot, but the official was right there. Even though Scheidler put it through, Felling gets the technical foul. And going to the line for the Rams will be Dave Hartz.
I don't know, Max, if it just happened, but it looked like they had two men on Scheidler as he came down the floor. As I said, that might have just... They might have switched and wound up with two men, but let's watch and see if they see if Buda Sheffield does put two men on him.
They haven't done anything to this point particularly to rearrange their defense to stop him other than just play him straight man-to-man. Anglin. That's gear on Anglin. Calvert in the corner. Looking inside. Hartz. Drives the left, right side, goes up and puts it in. That was a fine move by Dave Hartz. That's another technical on Ron Sully.
Ron Felling of Lawrenceville.
Dave Hartz will shoot the technical foul, and he makes this one. And Buda Western, Buda Sheffield, that is, will get the ball out of bounds. And they're down by 7 points. They were trailing by 10 at halftime. We were informed previously that Jay Scheidler now has 999 points on the year. Calvert inside to Hepek, his shot blocked nicely by Schmelz. Hesher. Nielsen with the rebound to Hartz. Anglin. Calvert with Pickering on him. That's Greer. Or Gear guarding Anglin. The ball looped under to Hepek. His shot up, no good. A tip, and finally another tip by Nielsen, and it is good.
Buda is slowly coming back into this ball game.
That they are.
You know, at the halftime, we talk about the shooting percentages. The Lawrenceville was 54%, but Buda was 52%.
Gear. Pickering. Anglin. Calvert. Jay Scheidler with the rebound. 3-on-2. Fine tip effort. Fine tip effort that time by Schnauz, but he didn't get it in. And Buda Sheffield will come down on the attack. Ed, your observation is perfectly right. There, we may be more concerned about records, but Buda Sheffield is concerned about winning this ball game, and they're coming back. And a foul called underneath, and it looks like it's on Rick Pickering. 4 minutes, 57 seconds remaining in the third period, and it. It's timeout in the third quarter. Scored 1,001 points.
Max, I didn't score 1,000 points in my entire high school career.
I don't think so. I don't think I could lump my grade school, high school, and college career together. Calvert with the ball for the Rams. Underneath it goes to Nielsen. His shot, no good. Apek gets the ball back. Now they're within five. Buda Sheffield. They are trailing two men on Scheidler. Calvert and Englund both are on him. We get a wider shot. We'll see that. They're going to have to come out now. See the two men on Scheidler just standing there. They're going to force Buda Sheffield. As a matter of fact, the official says you have to come out.
Yes.
You have to come out and force the play.
Now they go back to one man, single man coverage.
Well, they're going to two men right now. You'll see Calvert and Englund both on him. And we're going to have a foul called on Jay Scheidler.
Not in the bonus situation as yet, either team.
Second personal foul on Scheidler. Calvert. Englund. Englund working hard to get that ball inside. Now gets it to Calvert. Left baseline shot. Almost in. Taken off nicely by Schnauz. Quickly up the court comes Hersher. He gets the ball off to Stevens. He gets it to Scheidler. Outside. Lays it off to Gear. Gear to Hersher. Gear. Off, no good.
Beautiful.
Beautifully by Stevens. Louis Stevens was right there at the right time, Ed. Englund has the ball now for the Rams. Gets it inside to Nielsen. Hart from the corner. Buda Sheffield within six. Scheidler has scored 81 points today and tonight. Fine tip by Stevens. Can you believe that, Ed McCauley, that Scheidler scored 81 points today? Hayfest.
I used to go for a month and they'd say, how many did you get this month? 81 maybe, 82. Well, that makes you feel humble.
Nielsen. They are going to, they're coming back. 5 points now separate these two fine ball clubs. A very, very good ball game. Dave Hersher. Englund. Looking inside. That's Gear on him. Hart's Gear guarding Englund very closely. And high. Now he backs off to keep it from going inside. Now he finally gets it inside. We've got a whistle underneath. And a foul is on Jay Scheidler. That's his third personal foul. Scheidler still with only 2 points in this quarter. 2 minutes and 7 seconds to go. Englund. Calvert, his shot. Western comes back within five. And Lawrenceville's going to hold it out in front. So you guys have got to come out and play with it. Gear has it. Hart's on him. Schnauz gets the ball way out in front. Hesher shot up, no good. Rebounded, taken off nicely by Calvert. Englund. Gear still on him. Ball thrown out of bounds, and it's going to be awarded to Lawrenceville. Into the ballgame comes number 44, Rob Horton, and going out is Jeff Calvert. Lawrenceville in control with a minute 23 seconds in the third period. Scheidler finally gets it back, wants to make his move. He does, goes up.
Jay
Coach just said to himself, two men, three men, four men, cover me with the whole team. I'm going.
They're going to make it tough for him at 35. Jay Scheidler with 35 points. Underneath the ball, tip. We're going to have to wait and see. Going to let the official underneath call it. And Buda Sheffield retains control. Out in front to Hartz. He gets it inside. That's Horton to Hayback. His shot up. Will they count it? Three-second violation. And Lawrenceville gets the ball back with 51 seconds remaining in the third period. You know, Lawrenceville has been very fortunate. They've got some extremely good ball-handling guards. And that's what you need when you got a shooter like Scheidler. Hesher and Gear out in front.
I think they just give them to him, let the whole five of them cover him. I wouldn't
that's
be
right.
surprised if Jay could get it off and score.
He's going to get a 5-second count if he doesn't get rid of it. Now the Rams come out.
Now they go. He swings to the other side.
Hesher. 13 seconds on the clock. 11, 10. There he goes. The rebound fought for. Controlled by the Rams. 3 seconds. A desperation shot that just nicked. He's got 35 points. Hayback has 13. And Nielsen with 10. And Hartz with 11 for Buda Sheffield. Lawrenceville controls the ball. I'm surprised that they're doing this tactic. I really am, because I would think that they would really be interested in getting Scheidler as many opportunities as he possibly can. But again, I guess it's a tribute to them. They're interested in winning the game. And you can see that there's a shot taken from the corner by Hesher, but we've got a foul underneath on number 44, and that's Stevens. Foul called on Louis Stevens, and the Rams, who trail by 7 with 7 minutes and 30 seconds to go. Hart's in the corner, tried to get it to Hayback underneath. He's on the floor, scramble for the ball, loose ball. Oh, what an attempt. We have seen more diving attempts at balls or whatever in this series of games than I've seen in a long time. The effort is outstanding. That's Hesher in the corner. Gets it back out in front to Gear. You can see Jay Scheidler there. They're putting a man on him, and he's shadowing him very closely. That's Hesher. Scheidler just standing at the free throw line. Got two guys standing around him now. Lawrenceville content just to move the ball outside. They're going to try to pull Buda Sheffield out to them. Gear. He gets the ball to Stevens. Stevens lobs it way out in front. Hesher just moving around to Gear now. They're just going to pass the ball around. We've got 6 minutes and 28 seconds left in the ball game. Gear starts his drive. Now comes back out. There's Hesher back again. They're just going to be content to play with it. 53-46. Lawrenceville is up by 7. They're trying to draw the defensive ball club out. Hesher with it again on the right side.
I'll tell you, you're seeing something else right now, Max. The young man is going for a record, and he's doing exactly what his coach tells him to do. You might think he'd be coming out screaming for the ball, following orders, going with the game plan, looking for a victory.
That's Schnauz with the ball. Gets it off to Gear.
He hasn't handled the ball for a couple of minutes here.
Schnauz with it again. Back to Gear. Gear has it. That's Hesher underneath all alone. And we got a foul call. Underneath, that was Stevens. He found Louis Stevens underneath. And a foul was called on number 44, Rob Horton. That was his first personal foul. And Louis Stevens will go to the line. Lawrenceville, up to this point in the tournament, had averaged 65 points a game. That is in the from the super sectional on. And Buda Sheffield, 56. Lawrenceville controls that missed free throw. Gear has it again. 5 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in the ballgame. Lawrenceville is up by 7. Scheidler touches the ball for the first time. Gear. Scheidler. He may work it in. There it is. And they got it. And the foul is on number 50. Establish a new limit. Individual scoring record for 4 games. I had mentioned earlier that Jay Scheidler was shooting 85% from the free throw line during tournament play. He is now within 3 points of the all-time 4-game record. Buda Sheffield has the ball. That's Hart with the shot and brings them within 7. They've still got time to pull this game out. Lawrenceville leading 55-48 with 4 minutes. 27 seconds. A whistle and a foul is going to be called on Jeff Calvert. Going to the line will be Jay Scheidler.
Don't know if they're in the bonus yet. They're not in the bonus situation as yet.
No, they are not.
So they will inbound the ball.
Inbound the ball at the end of the court. Schnaups gets it to Hester in the front, and Scheidler took the handoff, and another foul on Jeff Calvert. They're still not in a bonus situation, and Lawrenceville's Dave Hesher will take it out. 4 minutes, 15 seconds remaining. Scheidler seems to be working to get the ball. And the roar from the stands behind us, Buda Western says, you didn't hit any iron that time. Hapek inside. Fine block by Nathan Schnaups. You know, Ed, we've seen a number of extremely good defensive plays in close around the basket, and that's tough. Difficult to do and not get that foul. Buda Sheffield controls it. Hapek has it. Hart from the right side. Off the front of the iron.
I'll say one thing. The Western School, Buda Sheffield, one way they could stop him from scoring is they would go into a stall, but they're not doing it. They're just taking their shots. They're going after the ball game.
That's Stevens to Gear. Escher. Stevens. Here, 3 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in the ballgame. Escher, Scheidler, he needs 3 to break the all-time 4-game record.
I'll tell you, he may not get it, Max.
He's not going for it.
No, he's just doing what he's told.
Scheidler with 37 points in this ballgame. He had 31 in the first half. And 46 seconds remaining in the ballgame. And a foul is called on number 24, Kevin Anglin. Couple substitutes, Pickering coming in for Lawrenceville and Giovanni coming in for the Rams of Buda Sheffield. Going to the line is Dave Hesher, the 5'9" senior. Done a fine job for the Indians of Lawrenceville. Beck comes off with it to Hart, and the Rams come down. They're down by 7, 2 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in the ballgame. Looking inside, shot is up and good. And Nielsen scored that for the Rams. Scheidler needs 1 point. Actually, he needs 2 points to break the record. He needs one to tie. Giovanni to Hart, to Hayback underneath, left side. Fine fake. Fine play by Ron Hayback. That's the first time I've seen Scheidler come down the floor last. That could be it. It is. Necessary to what's going on here.
Tonight, number 155 for the four-game tournament. He has set the all-time record for Illinois high school basketball tournaments. And gentlemen, I want to say something to you. That young man impressed me during that fourth period when he did exactly what his coach told him to do.
Good point. Ray Scott.
And man, he was going for a record. He got the ball and he passed it. He went where he was supposed to do to be, and it was if I'm going to do what I'm told. I'm just
Ray. You experienced the same tingling sensation I did when these fans stood and applauded that young man's achievement.
Really, it was a memorable moment.
Scheidler is 18 for 28 this evening. He's only one field goal away from the all-time tournament record field goals, 19. Judah Sheffield has it on the baseline. Fine basket. Minute and 6 seconds to go. Lawrenceville 61. The basket is good. Judah Sheffield 54.
I'll tell you, I played. Some people would say, what about the other team? I played in games. I can remember when I was a freshman in college, Bob Curlin set an NCAA record against me, 58 points in one game. And I'll tell you, I was proud to be there to see it. And People say, were you embarrassed? I was proud to see such a great performance. And I think these young men who have played against this young man in this tournament are always, they're going to remember it also, Max. I was there.
I can tell you this, that I can remember yet a somewhat similar experience, but nowhere near the number of points this young man had in Huff Gym when it happened to me, and he will remember it a long, long time. Pickering has fouled out of the ballgame, and we're getting some substitutes into the ballgame for both ball clubs.
I've known Jay for 5 years, and I'll tell you, he's a fine young man, and he just a great shooter and a great scorer, but I
think it's a tribute. It's a tribute to the whole ball club.
Yes, it is.
It took an awful lot of understanding by his teammates, I'm sure.
I hope to tell you, Dick. Hayback gets the free throw. And Judah Sheffield is at within six. Jay Scheidler is still in there. It's two time, gets the ball off to Gear. Hesher gets it back. He may shoot it from there. I wouldn't have been surprised at all had that one gone in. He is an exhausted young man right now.
Yes, I just hope, because I'd like to see him play as long as he can. I hope with 3 seconds left that something happens where they can take him out of the game.
Five personal fouls on Jeff Calvert. And he made a valiant effort tonight, spent much of his time guarding Jay Scheidler. 44 points.
Yeah, the total 156 now, Max, for the four games.
Going for our Lawrenceville is Pace. Scheidler has one more coming. 52 seconds on the clock. 45 points. Hearts to Giovanni. Anglin tries to get it inside. The ball goes out of bounds. A nice save by Brent Pace. And the Rams of Buda Sheffield will inbound it underneath their own basket. A lot of movement. I'm sure that Ron Felling will take Jay Scheidler out of the game, and the standing ovation he'll get will be unbelievable. Well, the young man, he's just getting tired.
Good, he's human.
Yep.
He's
absolutely.
Human.
Absolutely. Here he comes. Listen to this ovation. A happy young man and a very enthusiastic crowd.
Standing ovation.
Hearts, Anglin from the corner. And they're back within six with 19 seconds remaining. This the third place game of the 1976 Class A Illinois High School Championship. The foul is called on Giovanni. And going to the line will be Dave Wagner. We've got a number of substitutes now. Number 40, Terry Hashbrook comes in. Number 52, Cal Eichstein comes into the ballgame. Number 22, Bruce Gingrich comes in. Very happy Lawrenceville men. Ten seconds on the clock. And the free throw by Dave Wagner is good. Well, we haven't seen many better third place games than this one. The second free throw is good. And Lawrenceville, 65. Buda Sheffield 56 or 57. Coming out is Ron Habeck, and a young man who had an extremely, and I mean extremely, fine tournament. 9 seconds left on the clock. There's a shot by Greenwich. It's short. Rebound is fought for. We're going to have a jump ball with 1 second showing on the clock. Lawrenceville, the Lawrenceville Indians from Lawrence County in southwestern Illinois. There's the horn with the final score. Lawrenceville 65 and Buda Sheffield 57. We'll be back with a summary right now. Here's Ray Scott.
Thank you very much, Max. Enjoyed as much as we have this just remarkable. That's about all you can say. Remarkable third place game right now. Ron Felling and Chips Giovanni, the rival coaches here in this battle for third place, or as it's called sometimes, consolation game, are exchanging handshakes and chatting with each other. There are a lot of emotions involved. A lot of emotion involved in this third place game. On the one hand, I'm sure that the players from Buda Sheffield were saying, well, we don't want him to break the record against us. On the other hand, it was pretty obvious that the record was going to be within young Scheidler's grasp after he had that brilliant first half. And as it turned out, we have seen the setting of a new record all tournament for individual scoring. We're going to take you out on the floor now for coverage of the third and fourth place trophy presentations. And for this, we switch to Harry Fitzhugh, Executive Secretary of the Illinois High School Association.
Now for the presentation of the third and fourth place winners, Mr. Harry Fitzhugh, Executive Secretary of the Illinois High School Association.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce Mr. Roy Shepherd, the principal of Mattoon High School and vice president of the association, who will present the third and fourth place awards. He will be assisted by Mr. Richard Mariani, the superintendent of Islewood High School at Woodhull and secretary of the association, Mr. Don Millen? Pitbull, Pittsfield High School, a member of the board of directors, by Mr. H. David Fry, the assistant executive secretary of the Illinois High School Association. Roy?
Thank you, Mr. Fitzhugh. Certainly you have seen the best in interscholastic athletics here in this Class A tournament. The moment has arrived when we make the awards to true champions, and at this time I'd like to ask the coach of Western to come forward, please. Coach Giovanni. Congratulations, coach. I would like to present to you these medallions that you may present to your team members in recognition of this accomplishment. You have, with your team, represented interscholastic athletics for your community and your school. Thank you. And now if the captains, Kevin Anglin and Dave Hertz, will come forward, I'd like to present to you in recognition of a tremendous year in basketball, we present to you this fourth place trophy with our congratulations, young men. And now I would like to come forward a tremendous coach, Coach Ron Felling from Lawrenceville. Coach, congratulations, Coach. Speaking for all the member schools and the Illinois High School Association, we'd like to present to you these medallions that you will present to your team in recognition of their fine accomplishment.
Thank you very much.
Now I would like to call forward at this time a tremendous athlete, the captain of the Lawrenceville, Jay Scheidler. As part of a tremendous team from Lawrenceville, we recognize you as a truly outstanding player. And for the young men from Lawrenceville, we congratulate you on this third place. It's a tremendous ball team, a tremendous young man. Congratulations.
Thank you, Roy. In just a few minutes, our championship game will get underway. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are the individual point totals on this evening's third place game. First of all, for Buda,
well, Sheffield, not very much can be added. I don't think that ever anywhere could a so-called consolation game or game for third place have aroused so much dramatics. And it's really been a moment that all of us are going to remember. Now let's switch to Ed McCauley in Tournament Central.
Stay with us between games because we have a number of special features for you. Following Max Super's summary on the last encounter, we'll have an interview with the old guard. Also, Ray Scott will bring us a special report on all the communities represented by teams here in Champaign. And then Ray will join me as we bring you up-to-the-minute background on the two teams competing for the championship. And we'll get started after this.
Lawrenceville's 5,900 residents are veteran basketball fans, as this is the 12th state tournament appearance for the Lawrenceville Indians. They made their debut in the tournament in 1917 and won the Class A title in 1972 and 1974. This year, they brought a 27-1 record to the tournament and are ranked second in the state. The school has an enrollment of 741. Everyone gets into the basketball swing in Lawrenceville this time of year, but basketball isn't everything, as these young men will tell you. They're en route to their favorite fishing hole.